Hi everyone, it's the Math Sorcerer here with Chegg. In this video, we're going to be discussing the limit of a function. Let's do this example. So on the screen, you see the graph of a function, which is f of x, and we're going to answer all of these questions from this graph. Let's start with the very first one, part A, the limit of f of x as x approaches 1 from the left. So to figure this out, you basically go to the graph and you look on the x-axis for the number 1, which is right here. And x is getting close to 1 from the left. That's what the minus sign indicates, that it's from the left. So x is getting really, really, really close to 1, infinitely close. The question is, what is happening to f of x, which is the y value? Well, the y value is getting really, really close to 2. So as x approaches 1 from the left, the y value approaches 2. So in this case, the answer is going to be simply 2. Let's do the same thing, but now we're going to approach 1 from the right. In part B, we want the limit of f of x as x approaches 1 from the right. So approaching from the right, you can see that the y value also approaches 2. The answer is also 2. Part C, we want the limit of f of x as x approaches 1. This time, no direction is indicated. So whenever no direction is indicated, it's basically a two-sided limit. So if these are the same, then this is going to be the answer. And in this case, it is. If these numbers were different, then the answer would be does not exist. Part D wants us to compute f of 1. That's basically the y value when x is 1. So if we go to 1, we can see that the y value is 1, 2, 3, 4. The y value is 4. Part E wants us to find the limit of f of x as x approaches 4 from the left. We're going to be coming from this direction. And what happens there is that, well, looks like the graph is going down forever. The graph actually approaches negative infinity. That's what a function is approaching. Negative infinity would be the answer. Approaching 4 from the right, the graph gets big forever, so it's infinity. And then just approaching 4, well, we can't really get a common answer. So in this case, you would write DNE, which is does not exist. Let's do another example so you can get better at this. So here we have another graph, and we're going to answer the questions based off the graph. Part A wants us to find the limit as x approaches 2 from the left of f of x. If we look at our graph, here's 2, and we're approaching it from the left. So we're coming this way along the x-axis. So as you get infinitely close to 2 from the left, what's happening to the y value? Well, the y value is getting infinitely close to 1. And so the answer is 1. Likewise, if you approach 2 from the right, we ask ourselves, what happens when the x value gets infinitely close to 2 from the right? Well, the y value gets infinitely close to 3. The answer is 3 in this case. Part C is asking for the two-sided limit, or just the regular limit. We want the limit of f of x as x approaches 2. Because the one-sided limits are not equal, the answer here is does not exist. And we indicate that with the letters D and E. Part D wants us to find f of 2. F of 2 is the y value when x is 2. So if you look at the graph, here's x equals 2, the y value is also actually 2. So the answer here is 2. Part E wants us to find the limit of f of x as x approaches 1. So 1 is right here, I'm going to indicate it in red, and the graph actually goes right through 1. And if you approach from the left, you're just going to get 0. Approach from the right, you're just going to get 0. So therefore, the answer is 0 in this case. Now that you've seen some examples of limits from a graph, let's jump into something a little bit different. Determine the infinite limit. Let's do part A. We want the limit as x approaches 2 from the right of x plus 3 over x minus 2. Let's go ahead and work through this solution. These problems are a little bit tricky because there's no algebraic way to work it out. I'm just going to show you how I do it. So x is approaching 2 from the right. So in the numerator, we have x plus 3. So if you have a number close to 2 and you're adding 3, it's going to be positive. So the numerator is going to be a positive number. As for the denominator, we have x minus 2. In order to figure out whether that's going to be positive or negative, let's draw a little picture. So here's the number line, and here's 2. And we are approaching 2, from the right. That means x is over here because we're going from the right. Well, that means that x is bigger than 2. So now imagine, what's a number that's really, really close to 2 but bigger than 2? Something like 2.00001, right? It gets infinitely close, but let's pretend we could stop for a moment. We'd get something like 2.01 minus 2. You end up with a positive number over something like 0.01, or even smaller, right? The closer x gets to 2, the smaller this piece is going to become. So what happens is, whenever you have a positive number over something really, really small, it gets really, really, really big. So the answer here is going to be infinity. Again, when you have a positive number over something small, it gets really, really, really big. If you're not convinced, think about 1 over 0.1. That's equal to 10. 1 over 0.01. That's equal to 100. 1 over 0.001. That's equal to 1,000. So again, whenever the bottom piece is small, the whole fraction is going to be big. Let's do another example. Part B, we want the limit as x approaches 3 from the left of x plus 1 over x minus 3. Let's go ahead and work through this one very carefully. Solution. So in the numerator, we have x plus 1, and x is approaching 3. So if you have a number that's close to 3 and you're adding 1, it's going to be positive. So we have a positive number in the numerator in this problem. To figure out what's happening in the denominator, let's draw a little picture. So here's the number line. Here's 3. And we're approaching from the left. That means that x is over here. That means that x is less than 3. That means that we're going to have a number that's really, really close to 3, but smaller than 3. For example, 2.9. And really, we're not supposed to be stopping at any particular number, but just pretend for a moment we can stop. Minus 3. We have a positive number over negative 0.01. So what's happening here is, if you just look at the positive over 0.01, we know from before that whenever you have a number on the bottom, it's really, really, really big. So basically, this is negative, and it's really big. So this is going to approach negative infinity. Really nice. Hopefully, after watching this video, you feel like you're a little bit better at limits. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to check out other videos on Chegg. I hope this has been helpful. Good luck.